Okay, welcome guys. So 2015 is going to be a big year for Star Wars. It's the first year we're getting a first Star Wars movie in like a decade since the last one. So I decided to review two of the best Star Wars strategy games that are out there. So the first one I'm going to start with is Star Wars Empire at War. So this is a real-time strategy game where you can control either the Rebellion or the Empire. So let's start it off. I'm going to give you guys some bullet points here. And you have numerous things to choose. I'm probably going to choose the biggest here. Cool. I'm going to choose the Rebellion, of course, because I don't like playing the Empire. Many worlds have sworn allegiance to an alliance, but the Empire sees the Rebellion as a threat. So, I'm going to pause this real quick because you have your controls here. The game will go on if you don't pause it. So, one of the things that I noticed in this game, playing it, is a few differences. The map is not as epic as another game I'm going to show you, which is going to be a little later in this video. I'm going to save the best for last, of course. So, in this game right here, everything is a planet here, right? And each one has a color identifying which kind of side they're on. Anything in red is Empire. Anything in green is Alliance, is a Rebel Alliance. The only problem is if the developer knew or had any understanding of like the Star Wars universe, is the Alliance, the Rebel Alliance, is always in red and the Empire is always green. And it's just something I noticed the developer kind of screwed up on. But anyway. So a couple of cool things. There is a strategic element, which is what we're playing here. And you can go in and select a system. You could build like defenses like the ion cannon and things like that, turbo lasers for the ground. You can even build ships like X-wing squadrons and strong against Vader. That's cool. Okay, and then you can build like space stations and ships. If this place could build a ship, it would detail it right here, like there's Nebula B frigates like these guys have. This guy would be expensive to build. Or bigger space stations. So, that's the space element. And you can just kind of drag and drop. I'll give you an example. I have a fleet here. I want Han actually to command a fleet. I was wondering if I can actually do that. I know in the other game I can. Go here, Han. Han. Chewie. Go here.
Easier than the Kessel Run.
Dang right, it's easier than the Kessel Run. So he's gonna head over there. I'm gonna have him command his fleet. Speed this up a little bit. I don't know why it's taking him so long. Oh no, he's there already. My bad. Okay, so I have a fleet here. I want to show you how movement works in this game. So I'm gonna go after Endor here.
We can do that.
Quick, simple, easy. I like that. So playing the game is actually pretty easy. Just send your ships where you want them to go. Now, this is the other thing of the game. You have actual tactical battle. There's space and land, which is really cool. I haven't played these kind of tactical battles for a long time, so this is gonna be cool. Ow. Nice, beautiful. Oh. So, if you want to play Millennium Falcon, this is gonna be awesome because I have the Millennium Falcon right there. So, I have to attack something. And the cool thing about this game is... Okay, Luke.
We're counting on you to remove all
really?
The
me?
Wow.
If you do. Alright, cool. So, you select the units that you want to fight. So, I'm going to probably send in a couple X-Wing squadrons. You're going to be my scouts.
Asteroids ahead. Switch shields to double front. Ready for orders.
Jeez, I wonder if they're going to get messed up in the asteroid field.
Head we're over. Going in.
And I'm gonna have my capital ships.
Calling for Major Command. Armed and ready. Enemy forces ahead. Frigate reporting.
Okay, so.
Roger that.
We got a.
Running force en route. Target confirmed.
Now I'm gonna send the entire fleet.
What's on your mind? Easier than the Kessel Run.
So, we just have this guy here. So, I'm going to take care of them really quick. I'm gonna have Han.
Got something you need moved?
Let's go after. And I don't want to lose these squadrons, so they're going to fall back. I'm going to have this frigate. And you could actually select, this is pretty cool, you could actually select what you want to target at. I'm going to hit. I'm going to do Y-wings, they're going to go in for. I thought I lost Chewie there for a second. So as you can see, there's a lot of really cool graphics in this. Even zoom down. X-Wings. Oh, just hanging out back there. Let's go to work, guys. Take out these. So as you can see, there's some really epic combat in this. So there's also two things here. You see the blue and you see the yellow underneath it. That kind of identifies your shield and hull strength. Shield being blue. Let me throw someone X-Wing.
Bombers reporting in. Bombers clear.
Should really concentrate on these. So as you can see, the combat in this game is pretty epic. I think I lost his ship. Oh no, there it is. Cool, so that's a battle. As you can see, that was really cool. Now at this point here, there's not much you can do because you have to invade the planet Endor, and I don't have any actual forces to do that. I can send these garrisons here, or these tanks, and basically the objective of this game is to go planet hopping, in essence, almost like Pacific, right? You go from here, take this, take that. The only big problem that I have with this game, which is a huge kind of thing, and I really don't like it, is if I want to send a fleet from, like, let's say this fleet here, and I want to do, like, let's say a suicide mission to Coruscant, which is the capital of the Empire, I can't. I actually have to, hold on, I would have to go through this from here to here, or actually here to here, and I think, oh no, I can't even go from Bespin to Solace. I would have to go here, 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 think here, and then finally get to Biss, and then, I mean, that's a long, long process. It's kind of like Pacific Island hopping. Unfortunately, this is not the Pacific, okay? This is space, so if you want to go from one place to another, you can. It's not, like, you know, it's not two-dimensional. It's not go from point A to point B. You can bend space. You can go in, it's three-dimensional, you know? So, and especially with light speed, you don't have to go from planet to planet. You know, one thing I would love in this game is if I can go from here to Coruscant in a one straight path. But that was the biggest thing I didn't like about this game, was that, you know, you can't go from one spot to the other. The other thing is that like, each one is a planet. And they're supposed to represent this galaxy. And obviously, you know, it doesn't feel as epic. The next game that I'm going to show you has, it's a lot more epic in terms of scope. And it kind of gives you more immersion into the Star Wars universe. So, finalizing this, if I had to kind of give this game a score, this is a really great game. It's a 2006 game. It has some great graphics. It has some land battles, has space battles. You can control individual characters, build ships, build space stations, basically run the Rebellion or the Empire and actually have really great strategy experience. But if you want to take it up a notch, the next game will do it. Now, that other game is Star Wars Rebellion. Now, this is the other game, and I've saved the best for last because this, by far, is the best one. I'm going to choose medium. Now, you can actually play and buy this game. It just came up on Good Old Games.
I am C-3PO, Human-Cyborg Relations, and this is...
This is an older one from 1998, as you can see. Unfortunately, I played this game before, and you can't shut this guy up. At least I could have figured out a way. So we have to go through his little thing. But while he talks, hopefully you can hear me. Or actually, I'll mute him. So, starting out... Actually, I'm going to mute him because he's going to talk too much. So basically, as you can see, the game is really epic. The galaxy map is massive. As you can see right here, each dot is a planet. So there's a lot more planets in here than the actual Empire at War. And it's a much greater scope in terms of a strategy game. So that's one real cool thing I love about this game. Other cool things that makes it really shine is the Coruscant is right here. This is where the Empire's headquarters is, and I believe it's this moon right here, right where the T is supposed to be. Now, technically, in this game, you can actually develop a fleet in this outer rim where, like, the Empire doesn't know where you're at, and actually send them from here to here without having to going here to here to here to here to here to here, like in the other game. Hopefully, he's done by now. No. And going into it, this game is much more complex and much more in-depth than the previous game. If I had to kind of compare them to, it's kind of like the difference between playing Risk, the board game, and playing something like World in Flames or Axis and Allies. Something much more in-depth, much more greater in scope. So I always recommend people, if you are trying to play a simple Star Wars strategy game, go with Empire at War. If you really want to go into the game and actually feel like you're inside that Star Wars universe and playing grand strategy on a grand scale, this is the game. You can control a lot more characters. In the other one, you probably saw only like three. And that's basically where it ends, in essence. There might be a few more, but that's about it. In this game, there's literally dozens of characters that you have to control, and they actually do a lot of cool stuff. So in the last game, you saw Han Solo leading the fleet, and he can do that in this game too. However, you can assign him for other things. You can assign him to a diplomatic mission, an espionage mission, to rebuild, do ship research, things like that. Something really in-depth. You have full control of your characters, and it's incredible. So I'm going to actually pause this game, because this is also a real-time strategy game. You have to kind of do that. Pause. There we go. Oh, actually, it won't actually even let me. All right. I guess you have to. But here, this is really cool. So as you can see, there's a lot of planets here. A lot. And you have Coruscant here. So the game is like epic in scope here. And nobody knows what these planets are, so I can actually send a fleet there. And you actually control the fleets. Who's in command? This guy Tarlan is in command of that fleet. You have two regiments in that fleet. and all these characters you can control. So obviously it's a lot more than the previous one. You can issue missions to these guys. So you can say, all right, I want you to do a mission to Yavin. And I want you to do... Actually, there's only Espeon on a mission there. But it kind of gives you the... let's see. Oop, go this way. I want you to do a mission to here. And you can do a diplomacy mission, espionage mission. And depending on the planet, you can do a lot of real cool things. Each planet has like a... allegiance, so like kind of like red would be they're more in favor of the alliance than the empire, and depending on the battles that you fight and like or the things that you do in the game, that meter kind of goes back and forth, which is really cool. So usually in this game is really epic. Do not think you're gonna get into this game and finish it in a couple hours. This takes probably days. Like I said, this is kind of like World in Flames, kind of Axis and Allies kind of thing. Oh, I really need to move this. This is the headquarters of the Alliance, and I don't want them there. So what I usually go for is, if you are a Star Wars fan, I usually go here, Hoth. So I'm actually gonna send a fleet to Hoth, because I need to get this person here hidden, because if she's captured or something like that, it would be really bad. I'm gonna send...
I'm sorry, unfortunately that fleet is filled to capacity. I'm afraid.
So as you can see what happened there, I tried to move more people into here and I couldn't, because it's not, it can't carry more than that. It only has one transport there. So I'm actually gonna send this fleet to Hoth. And this is the real cool thing I love about the game. Now, this is a fleet that's in this system, and Trababa, whatever its name, is over here. You can literally just drag and drop, and now I just sent the fleet to Hoth. Now, they probably won't get there until status day 116. So it's gonna be a long time before they get there, but they don't actually have to pass through any of these other systems, which is awesome. Now the problem is, the reason why I'm moving my headquarters, because once Mon Mothma gets there, I'm gonna move this headquarters over there. And the reason I want to do that is because this is after the fourth movie, when Luke and Han destroyed the Death Star, which is actually took place on this planet. The Empire knows the Rebels are there, so they're gonna come after full load. It's kind of like right before Pearl Harbor, and you know the Empire is gonna smack the main fleet, kind of. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to evacuate everybody to probably this planet here until I can... So when the Empire gets to Yavin, there's not going to be nobody there.
You got it. You got it.
I love those... Can I select more than one? No. You have to do one at a time, unfortunately. And I'm not going to have anything there for the Empire to mess with. So when they come, there's not going to be anybody remaining. And I'm not going to give them anything. So I'm going to scrap that. Alright, so I literally evacuated Yavin. There's nothing there. And I moved the entire force there. As you can see, they're all in transit. They'll get there by day 10. So that's a really cool thing. Now, the first thing you want to do in this game is, because you really can't do much as the Alliance in the beginning. As the Empire, you can build ships because you're already set up. You're a government, in essence. We're the Rebels. We have to think outside the box, right? So, oh, that's the Empire. They're already building stuff. I need to build stuff. So as you can see, I don't have any places that actually can develop fleets. I have one fleet here. And most of these, I'm looking for a place that has a shipyard. As one. Now you want to get more ships, more shipyards, and you can build all these ships. Now none of these ships can really penetrate a Star Destroyer. So at this point, I'm just running from the Empire, because I have to develop ship research to make better ships to actually penetrate the shielding on a Star Destroyer or a Death Star. So at this point, we're just on the run until we can get better. Now the trick to do that is to develop ship research. So as you can see, to finalize these two strategy games, I can't go into a battle here because maybe I could actually. Is there an Empire fleet I can show you guys? I can't find them. Actually, let's go to Coruscant. Maybe I can show you guys. There's actually Corellian. So I'll try to show you the thing here. Maybe I can give you like a little battle simulation. Now, mind you, this is 1998, so
it's far off. From Captain Solo.
Good. Units arrive at Ektish. Okay, so my ships are gonna arrive here when? Alright, so this is how it works for this battle fleet on here. They probably have a Star Destroyer. Yeah, they have a lot of Star Destroyer. Yeah, I know, Luke. So this is what the tactical element of this game looks like. It's not like the other game. Obviously, right? I'm gonna get my butt kicked. Alright. I think I'm concentrating on the Star Destroyer. It's been like a decade and a half since I played this game. So as you can see, it's not as as graphically immense as the 2006 game. It's amazing what literally 8 years can do in terms of graphics. It's basic. It's not even internet level graphics. It's not. It's basically like iPhone 1 graphics. This would be cool to be on the new iPhone, which I'm actually going to get to in a second. So as you can see, these are your shielding, that's your hull, kind of like the other one. I'm trying to go up to the Star Destroyer to start firing on it. Now these Corellian Corvettes, they don't have any firepower. The other ship's probably destroyed at this point. Yeah, its shields are down, and it's about to be destroyed. There's two Alliance regiments on there. I just kind of... Yep, I could see that. So as you can see, I'm hitting this Star Destroyer, and obviously I'm not doing any damage. So let's go to TIE Fighters. So obviously this was a stupid move to attack the Empire. I just wanted to show you the tactical element, but this is kind of like U.S. fleet in 1942 invading Tokyo, kind of thing. Cool. Alright, so that's how that is. Now, obviously, this is not going to be an epic graphical game. It's meant for scope, it's meant for gravity, how awesome, how epic this strategy game is. Now, one thing that I would recommend to Disney, who actually controls Star Wars, if you can combine the tactical element of the 2006 game, improve the graphics maybe a little bit more, and take the scope and gravity and epicness of this huge strategy section of the strategic warfare here, and mix those two games together, you'll have an epic Star Wars game. Epic. And I would love to see it, if I could add my two cents, on an iPad, which would be awesome. I would play on a desktop too, but an iPad and iPhone would be awesome. Anyway, that does it. These are my two favorite Star Wars games. This, Star Wars Rebellion, is by far the best Star Wars game I ever played, and I would have to say in my top five strategy games I ever played in my life, this definitely is in my top five. Probably closer, maybe to, if I would have to guess, probably the top number three. I would have to say there's only one or two games that are above this in terms of my favorite. So that does it for this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you guys try these games out. This game's on Good Old Games right now. It's on sale for today because this is Star Wars Day. And the other game is also available on sale on Good Old Games, as well as Steam, as well as the Mac App Store. So you can get on any three for Empire at War. And that's basically it, guys. I hope you are going to enjoy this year, especially in December when the new Star Wars movie comes out. And hopefully we'll see some really cool Star Wars strategy games coming out this year or in the years to come.